Hi and welcome to Ljubljana, the capital of Slovenia. I'm Inga and I am the press officer for the Socialists and Democrats, the second largest group in the European Parliament. Today we are gathered at the beautiful Kongresny Targ, the Congress Square of Ljubljana. Ljubljana is already the 16th city on our Europe Together tour, the initiative we started 2.5 years ago. So the idea is to leave Brussels and to come to you, to the city you live, to debate with you your ideas about Europe. We are at the very important times, less than 3 months ahead of the European elections, so obviously our workshops today, our discussions were focused on the future of Europe. We had a chance to talk with some of Ljubljana habitants, and please see what they said when we asked them about Europe, what does it mean for them to be European, and what are the biggest challenges Europe is facing now.
Europe for me represents a big spectrum of opportunity, especially for young people, since we have all those arrangements that we can do within Europe, for example Erasmus exchange and also different working opportunities. So I think it is a big possibility for all of us to engage with different cultures, with different countries, to learn new languages and also to meet new people from different countries and experience the world.
I'm Carol and I'm here in Ljubljana for, yesterday it was exactly 1 month. I'm here for Erasmus and I arrived from Czech Republic, from Ostrava. Ostrava where I live, but I'm studying in Brno. For me it's a great chance to travel somewhere, like everywhere, just with ID. So it's super easy and my grandma is kind of jealous because during communism she couldn't do anything.
People say that small countries work better in a big union or so I think if we would be completely independent, I mean we are, but if we would be completely independent, I don't know if we would work that well like we do in the European Union. I think it's a good thing for Slovenia to be in the European Union.
I think it's a good thing to unite many different nations, many different cultures, because that brings understanding to from people to people, and I think it brings joy and union amongst people in Europe. So I wish for further connection throughout countries down east and so on, because I think bringing different cultures together in the beginning is hard, but the more people get to know each other, the more understanding there is, and the connection is way better that way.
Like I think there are some like dangerous like ideas thinking, but like so far for me it doesn't seem that bad. Like I don't know, I can see in Czech Republic people who like want to leave and they don't want to be in Europe, but like most of the young people are pro Europe, I think. So
that kind of wave of populism or ultra right parties will have a power in Europe, because I think that Brussels and European Union is strong enough to struggle all these things. So actually we see Great Britain, so England, with Brexit, but actually they realized that it was a huge mistake maybe, but actually I think that the Europe became very strong, and I think that the people who are sitting in this let's say organization are strong enough with that project that it will keep Europe united.
I don't know, like I don't see actually like maybe where the money goes, to be honest. Like there are so many institutions and we don't see like what they really do. So maybe that's like kind of would be better to know more about it.
I think I'm proud to be from Europe. I mean, I'm even prouder to be Slovenian, but I'm also proud to be European.
It can give an open possibility to all people, especially for young people, to explore the other part of this world, but actually Europe after the period of communism and socialism that struggled in this part of Europe for a long time, after the Second World War. So actually it's still going on, it's still nice to see, especially new generations living plenty life with full open hands. So hope it will last.
Well, I think it is our duty as European citizens to vote in the European elections and contribute our vote and decide on the future of Europe. And of course, Europe is in crisis, but Europe has in a way always been in a crisis, always dealing with different challenges coming along the way. So I think Europe can manage to deal with all of the challenges that come its way also now.
Welcome back. I am now joined by Blaž from Students Organization of University of Ljubljana. Hello.
Hi.
We just heard some young Slovenians telling us why Europe matters for them. Does Europe matter for you?
Of course it does. I mean, especially with the worrying trends that we've been seeing in the recent years, I think that a strong European Union is something we really need, and I'm really happy that S&D is really focusing in their campaign on this part of the of how important actually European Union is to young people and how many benefits do we get from it.
And Blaž, you seem very young. How old are you?
I'm 21.
So the May election will be the first election, European election, you are going to vote, yes?
Actually, it will be, yes.
Yes, going to vote?
Of course.
Why?
Well, because I think it's part of the responsibility that you have as a European citizen. You have to express your opinion.
But you know, at the last European election, the turnout in Slovenia was very low, only 24%. So how to make young people like you engage and go and vote?
That's a very hard question, I'd say. I'd say that one of the first things we can do is to try to present to the young people how many benefits do they get from the EU and how important it is for the EU to function properly and perhaps in this way. But otherwise, it's a really more of a hard sociological question, if you ask me. So the bottom line being that just, yeah, making young people see what everything EU does for them.
Thank you very much. I'm now joined by Tania Fajon, the Vice President of Socialists and Democrats in the European Parliament and the head of Slovenian delegation. Tania, thank you for hosting us in your beautiful hometown, Ljubljana. The title of today's event is Europe We Need. So, in your view, what Europe we need?
First of all, I would like to say I'm very glad, I'm very proud to host this event, Together Europe in Ljubljana. It's a spring day, but it's not only spring that we feel in our hearts today, it's also the spring we feel with young population seeing in Europe that they are mobilizing because they want to have back Europe that is different, that is better. We want to come back to the values like solidarity, social justice, democracy. All this is threatened today with very dangerous nationalistic and populistic rhetoric, and being today in this beautiful city of Ljubljana with a lot of tourists, with a lot of Europeans, I would say we are like at the heart of Europe, and that's what we will discuss also today, the Europe that we want. And this is a better Europe, it's a Europe with solidarity, democracy and social justice.
Tanya, in less than 100 days we will have the European election. What's at stake? How to engage people to vote in this election?
I mean, in Slovenia we have the experience that there is a low turnout. It's not the only country, but I think the biggest challenge will be how to engage people, how to tell them that these European elections are extremely important, maybe the most important in the last 30 or 40 years, because we are at an important crossroad. What kind of Europe do we want? Whether we will have solidarity or no solidarity, social Europe or no social Europe. We are facing, as I said before, a lot of populism and nationalism. We see here in Italy, in Austria, in Croatia and in Hungary, nationalistic politicians, and this is what is at stake. So I really want to engage young people. We have Erasmus Plus, we have Open Europe, Open Borders, that especially young people would feel this European identity, and that we convince them that they are back part of the European process. So it will be a challenge for us, for politicians, but I'm strongly convinced, I grew up with this Europe, that we will manage also to somehow bring confidence back with our citizens, with work, against fascism, for solidarity.
You, as a former journalist, you must understand better than others how important the freedom of speech is and the open discussion, open public discussion. How how can we guarantee that internet is still open space, but we can guarantee that people are treated with dignity.
Yeah. Hate speech has always existed, also fake news, but today what is the challenge are social media, because it's spreading much faster. Today everyone can say everything, but I think what is a bigger difficulty is that mainstream politics and mainstream media start using this hate speech and fake news. We have to raise awareness, we have to speak aloud, also us politicians, we have to be louder to fight against this, to stop this trend of fake news, of hate speech, of intolerance in Europe. Not only mainstream politicians, but also media. Media play a very important role, and I hope during this campaign that we will manage through the media and through the dialogue with our citizens really also counter against this hate speech that exists. I mean, it's enough if you look to our neighboring country, Hungary, because there the gathering like that is almost impossible. The civil society, the academic liberties, this is something which I feel the openness we have in this city, that it's one of the safest cities, that tourists can walk around, that we are proud to be Slovenians, but we are proud to be Europeans. I think this identity we should really care for.
Tanya, in May we will celebrate 15th anniversary of this big enlargement when Slovenia joined the EU. What is the place of Slovenia today, 15 years after?
We are a very prosperous country. We have a safe life. We are today in the capital that is one of the greenest and safest capital in Europe, and not only in Europe, in the world. With the European enlargement, we are still the biggest net receiver. Every village in Slovenia had a street, had a hospital, has a school that is also renovated or built with European money. Young people can use Erasmus, they can travel, they can study abroad. This is for us Europe. We dreamt about that Europe, and I hope this dream will stay and we will build again Europe that we will be proud of.
Thank you very much.
I have seen this great nation develop into something which is a pearl in the crown of Europe. This is the crossroads where three great European cultures have been meeting for centuries and centuries. This is where the Germanic, the Slavonic, and the Latin world meet and interact without confrontation, on the basis of friendship. Yes, we know that some parts of our history were bloody. That's exactly the reason why we don't want ever to go back there, and we want to work on a Europe which is based on borderless Europe, on a Europe where we found a society on solidarity, on working together with others, so that we create a Europe that is fairer, that is stronger, that is better, that stands up for our values, that makes our children dream again, that takes poverty and throws it out, that makes sure that all of us can profit from a Europe that is stronger, fairer, and free. Thank you very much. Have a great evening. Thank you.
How was your day here in Slovenia? Do you feel inspired by Slovenians?
Oh man, it's such a beautiful city. We cycled around, we walked around, we talked to many people. You know, because I've been coming here for so many years, I see the change, and the change is very positive. That's thanks to the Slovenian people, but it's also thanks to the European Union. So, you know, it gives me inspiration to fight for the next European elections.
Vice President, you are the most prominent face of the European Commission when it comes to the fight for the rule of law, open society. Let me ask you directly, are we winning this fight?
Of course we're going to win this fight, but it's not going to be an easy fight, and it's going to be a long fight. And we need allies, we need to convince people that this is in everybody's interest. But yes, we're going to win this fight.
And the last question, because we spoke to many young people here in Slovenia, and you know, the financial crisis is over, but we still have huge unemployment. Also the young people, they feel somehow, you know, that Europe doesn't work, that they are left behind, will never be able to afford to buy a house like the parents were able. So what Europe can do about it?
I think
I think my top priority is a minimum wage. That will immediately help young people. Second priority is to put an end to these contracts, which are not real contracts, to give people real jobs with real protection. That's my second priority. The third priority is we need to tackle the housing crisis. Everywhere I go, I get remarks about the housing crisis. I would say we need to put European funds there where people, if cities like here or anywhere, if they decide to do new building projects, that we say to them, if you do a certain percentage of social housing, we will support you with the European funds. This is what we need to be doing in the future, so that we create affordable housing for young people everywhere in Europe.
Thank you.
Sure. My pleasure.
That's all for today. I hope you enjoyed, and the debate on Europe, of course, continues on our Europe Together platform.